It's just after 7 o'clock, and the doors are due to be opening for the Make It Big entertainment extravaganza. But one act down, the guests are being held outside.
We've got a great band, we've got a great juggling act, we've got Freddie the Magician.
Kieran has an idea. The dancers were going to do 20 minutes, as was Freddie the Magician.
Freddie, I've got a problem.
Right.
So would you mind doing your whole 40-minute performance, please? Because both dances have been cancelled.
All right.
The problem resolved. It's time for the event to begin.
Everyone, I need you in places now. People are coming.
Everyone, people are going to be coming.
People in places now.
Go.
Jess, Daisy, please get in position.
Everybody into places.
Everyone in position.
So excited.
Finally, the doors open and the guests pour in.
121. Look.
Life is a. As does the money, not only from ticket sales, but also for the raffle.
That's great, thanks.
Would you like to buy a schedule for tonight?
Thank you.
Amongst the guests is Five's children's presenter, David Payne.
Despite
being one of the celebrities Alana has booked, David walks straight past Suraj unnoticed. But Alana spots him as he passes by.
I think David Payne just walked in and didn't sit in the VIP area.
Where's David Payne?
Suraj. I'm guessing he looks like that.
I thought I saw him.
So the two start searching and finally clock him amongst the 150 guests.
Alana.
Right there at the back.
I'll go talk to him, yeah.
After all of Alana's VIP area preparation, David will be her first guest.
David Payne? Would you like to sit in the VIP area?
Is it all right? Well, yeah.
Oh, that's fine, yeah.
That's right.
Alana, show him to their seats.
David may be sorted, but the night's schedule still isn't. Kieran is reorganising it with the help of Johnny's assistant, Alison.
Could you swap those two around? And Freddie's doing 40 minutes, so that'll finish at 9:05.
Slight problem, and I don't know what Julia Roberts looks like.
I'll call on the microphone.
Hello? We have a slight problem, as in we have this celebrity come in called Julia Roberts, but not the Julia Roberts. And, we don't know what she looks like, so if you're Julia Roberts, could you step forwards, please?
It would seem Julia hasn't arrived, although the next celebrity, presenter Michael Underwood, is about to. But Alana is not impressed with Charlotte's celebrity spotting technique.
What did you do that for?
I was looking to see if...
Go back inside.
Fortunately, this time, they don't miss Michael.
Nice to meet you, Michael.
Hello, Michael.
So, what's the plan for tonight?
This is Alana, by the way. She's a celebrity booker.
Hello, nice to meet you.
Yeah, we're having to present all the acts and, like, compare the evening.
That's the newest.
But Kieran has only just sorted the acts that Michael will be comparing. He's handing out the newly printed running order, which Michael will need as host of the show.
Brilliant, excellent. So you're going to go grab a list for me of the acts and stuff so we can get through that. Nice one.
She would if she could, but there's now another problem with the new running order.
20 past 8.
Oh, you're joking.
No, you've got 20 past 8 till 20 past 9, and it's only 40 minutes, so it should go until 9 o'clock.
Freddie only does 40 minutes.
Right, so there's no mistakes on there, is there?
With only 10 minutes to go before the show, Kieran rushes off to deliver the new schedule, and Alana gives it to her celebs.
That's the running order.
Okay, great.
Yeah, I'm just really changed, I'll let you know.
Meanwhile, the girls are busy selling raffle tickets.
How much are they, Diz?
£1 a thingly bobbly.
At a price of £1 for a strip of 5 tickets.
Cash box.
Jess delivers the raffle taking so far, mixing it in with the ticket cash.
Whoa! Nathan made a lot of money.
Can I have the whole Make It Big group in, please? Everyone?
Gino, you stay there. Keep this man.
Suraj summons the team to the stage to kick off the show.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the cabaret. Welcome to Make It Big's event. Hope you're all good tonight. Can everyone put their hands together for Michael Underwood?
The first act is due on stage any second.
Give a warm round of applause, please,
for feeding the fish!
Kieran needn't have worried, as Feeding the Fish are already getting the show started. And finally, after 5 weeks' work, it's all coming together.
Yes! I can't believe this. I really can't believe this. It's happening. It's all paid off.
As Alana's next celebrity booking, cricketer Jeff Lawson arrives.
Are you Jeff Lawson?
That's me.
Yeah. Oh, hi. I'm Alana.
How are you going?
Kieran is racing to fetch his next act, Freddie the Magician.
Freddie! You ready for me?
It's 20 past minute.
What time is it? Just gone quarter past.
Yeah, well, they'll be finished. Yeah, come down now.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to give him a huge round of applause. He's our very special Freddie the Magician, ladies! Thank you.
As Freddie takes to the stage, behind it, Michael, who's also hosting the auction, is looking for Charlotte, who, shoeless, responds to his call.
Hello.
Hey, bye.
I'm a little bit worried because I don't have a list of what we've got for the auction, and I don't have a list of reserve prices, so I don't really know what we've got to do.
Josh, where's the auction list?
Auction list on the computer. Do you need it now?
I've got it. I need it now.
But the situation is about to be complicated as more auction items are arriving, courtesy of Shopping Channel presenter Julia Roberts, Alana's final celebrity.
Hi, are those the auction items?
Yes.
If you just leave them here, I'll get someone to pick them up later.
Okay, I haven't actually listed what there is.
So the new items will need to be added to the list with a starting price. Meanwhile, the raffle ticket strips are still selling well. As Alana goes in search of help with valuing Julia's items.
What else is there to do?
I really do need to help with this. I need someone to help me. I need to value jewellery.
I'll come and do it. Come on,
with no idea how much the jewellery's worth, the pair get down to guessing.
I will show you them. So you can value them. A bracelet.
Okay. I don't know how much that's worth. I don't know if it's real.
Oh, just, I need some help. Anybody, just help.
£2,000.
Seriously, Siraj.
Is it real?
I don't know.
Probably not. Okay. Let's go £50.
£50.
But with the interval nearing, Siraj leaves Alana to finish the list.
Print.
Our special guest, Jeff Lawson, will be here to draw the raffle. So give Jeff a round of applause. Come on, everyone. Jeff, we'd like to pick out the lucky number.
I've got the revised auction list.
Oh, right, excellent. This is with all the new stuff on now.
I think, it should have everything on.
First prize, number 305.
That's the list of the money, and that matches the list of the stuff.
Yeah, it wouldn't print on one page.
Gotcha.
Yeah, that's just an estimation. Feel free to change it, because we're not very good at valuing things.
The raffle over, Charlotte tells Jeff the amount raised.
£1,000 down the raffle, so well done. You still don't really want to.
But accountant Josh is concerned the figures don't tally.
Jess told me we made over £1,000 in the raffle. Charlotte said that. Siraj said that. Are you sure she didn't put the money there?
They don't have anywhere near £1,000 in the cash tin, and that includes ticket sales money.
No chance, I'll believe you. Don't need to go through it all.
£759.
So Josh goes to speak to the boss about his concern.
I need to talk to you urgently. It's raffle money. There's a real dispute over it. Jess, you're saying you put in the red ball, but Fraz, you can control the red ball.
Jess did put the money in the tin, so it would seem there's several £100 missing.
But there's only £600 and something pound in there, and Charles said he made over £1,000.